Hello, this is Virtual Dave. Virtual Dave has made another little video. I've not made one for such a long time. So I thought it's high time that I made another one. Just a little flight in Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020. Sitting in the Cessna Skyhawk. And got a Garmin G1000 screens there. This is like an updated version. We're sitting at High Wycombe Air Park and we are going to take off and we are going to fly up to Sywell Airport, our home airport, just in time for Sunday dinner. Hopefully, if it ain't burnt, if everything goes all right and I don't crash. Anyway, let's get this. I'll just show you this aircraft, what it is. There it is. It's got my 1968 date of birth on it. Lovely black and white. There I am, me buddy. Cessna Skyhawk. Awesome. I don't know why our trucks just stopped there for. Probably immigration. Moving now, must have heard me. So let's get this aircraft started and then we'll be on our way up there in the sky.
TARS system test.
First
okay.
Of all, got to turn on the batteries. There's nothing's going to work. And then the avionics. Okay. Get rid of that annoying beeping sound. Turn this on. I'm going to set up autopilot for probably, I'll set up 4,300 feet, I think, roughly the height we should be going at. So, well, it's 5,000, so there's 4,000. We'll go up in ones. 4,300, we'll see how that is. Turn on the flight director. Turn that, so I've got the magenta line, and turn on nav mode and turn on vertical speed mode, which then tells the aircraft how fast to rise when I move this blue dial up. So at the moment it's going to go up 900 feet a minute and I want it to go about 600 feet a minute. So when we're up in the air, all I should have to do is press autopilot and the plane should take over from me with any luck. I need to turn on the strobe light, the nav light, taxi light, the beacon light. I need to give it a little bit of throttle there. We'll put in a bit of the mixture. Actually, first of all, I'm going to request pushback. So let's tune into ground.
Wycombe Ground, Virtual Dave 6-8 requesting pushback.
It's a little bit dark.
Virtual Dave 6-8 pushback request accepted.
Must be under a big cloud up there, I suppose. Yeah, look at it. I'm going to put down one notch of flaps while we're getting pushed back. Don't need pushing back far. Hold on, buddy. Let me take the
Wycombe Ground, Virtual Dave 6-8 requesting the end of pushback.
Thank you, buddy.
Virtual Dave 6-8 request to end pushback received.
Now I need to turn on the engines.
Wycombe Ground, Virtual Dave 6-8 request taxi for north departure.
Virtual Dave 6-8 taxi to an hold short of runway 6 left using taxiway Alpha Bravo cross runway 17 Bravo. Contact tower on ONE 26.55 when ready.
Taxiing hold short runway 6 left via taxiway Alpha Bravo.
We need to
cross
be going that way then. I've got
Bravo,
these blue
Virtual
lines
Dave
because
6-8.
I always get lost at airports. So we've got a hold short of runway because I'm on a live server as well, so there is other aircraft flying and taking off. So we have to be a little bit careful. I have to be a little bit careful here and all. I don't chop that geezer's head off. One over your head, buddy. Okay. Turn onto this, this is a grass taxiway. I'd like to, at some stage, be able to do this without these blue lines. But, so many airports on this sim. And without, like, a map of the airport itself, like, as a PDF file or something. It's easy to get lost. Of a way to go. This airport is also used for hang gliding. Just to the, this airport is just to the west of High Wycombe.
Tower Virtual Dave 6, okay. Ready for north departure at runway 6 left.
Virtual Dave 6 8 cleared for takeoff runway 6 left, north departure.
Cleared for takeoff.
Cleared for takeoff runway 6 left, virtual Dave.
There was
Dave
another
6,
aircraft sort of coming in, or we'd have been told to hold. Hold short. Okay. We are now on the end of the runway with some horrible, it's not a horrible cloud, is it? Well, it's pretty dark looking. Okay, let's jump back in. Okay, parking brakes off, flaps down. Throttle up. Try and keep us centered along the runway. Rotate. So there's a plane to my left somewhere. We're gonna be banking left now.
Virtual Dave 6, it continues for north departure. I will contact you next when you leave my airspace.
Wycombe Tower Virtual Dave 6, 8 continue for north departure.
There's a plane on my left somewhere, but I don't know the height of it. It's probably above the clouds. You can see it on that map. It's actually it's going across. Okay, let's get back on this course line, then I can kick in autopilot. So that's High Wycombe over there. Football stadium down there, look. It's a High Wycombe Football Club, I suppose. Okay. Put on autopilot, let it turn us. Currently now under autopilot control.
Stall, stall.
And stall. Going up too stall. Steep.
Stall.
Just trying to sort of gain altitude too fast. It doesn't like it. Autopilot's trying to level us out a little bit now. Marble cloud. Looks like we're coming into some nice blue cloud though. Okay. So maybe now we can increase our to 500 feet a minute. This should be about a 27-minute flight, 30-minute flight.
Tower Virtual Dave 6-8 frequency change. Benson approach Virtual Dave 6-8 is type Cessna Skyhawk 5 miles north of Wycombe. Request flight following.
Virtual Dave 6-8 Benson approach. Squawk 7516.
Squawk 7516 Virtual Dave 6-8.
Virtual Dave 6-8 radar contact 5 miles north of Wycombe 2,700 feet.
So just up on our left there, down there,
copy,
is a place called Prince's Risborough. Never heard of it. It's a little village, I suppose. Not too far from London here, are we? Tracking, I've got my head tracking. Alexa, resume music. Let's have a little bit of classical music while we're floating in the sky.
Thank you.
Majestic. Majestic sounds... Look out the window, listen to that, and just forget about all the worries in life. So we're on course now to go straight over Aylesbury, which is dead ahead of us. Just down there, as you can see in the distance. Oops, my head tracking. So we're still climbing. 3,900 feet. So we're nearly at our ceiling height. Clouds are pretty high though. Going through a few of them. Awesome looking simulator, considering when, like, we used to play Microsoft Flight Simulator 2000 or something, or 1988, you know, it was just lines and blocks. Now look at it. Now look at it, it's so realistic. You'd be hard pressed to tell the difference between if you took a video out of a Cessna like that. You'd be hard pressed to tell the difference between this and the sim. The sim and the real thing.
Going to 122.855 virtual Dave 68. Cranfield approach virtual Dave 68 4,300 feet.
Virtual Dave 68 Cranfield approach continue as planned. Altimeter 29.92.
Autopilot is awesome, man. Because you can just sit back and enjoy the view, as long as you keep an eye now and then on some of these let's pull the RPMs back slightly, make sure it's in the green, just sit back and enjoy the view. Yeah, so we've gone directly over Aylesbury. She's down there. I'm so realistic. And to think that I could actually fly down there and land in one of those fields if I want. And the trees will look like trees, the grass looks like grass. It's amazing. What's it going to be like in another 30 years, man, for our kids, our grandchildren and that? Probably be something like 8, 10k, 16k. Stunning. It's just, I can just sit in silence, man. Look out the window. All the little villages are maps, look. So that down there is called Whitechurch. Whitechurch Village. One down there called Creslow. Creslow Village. So we ain't gonna see much in a minute. You have thunder in this game, you have lightning, you have rain, you have rainbows. And the clouds, they cast shadow upon the ground. Sounds like a prayer. Amen. Keep flying, we should be coming out of it. Look at that. What was that? Maybe that was my head tracking and I thought something happened to the plane. It's just my head tracking. Can't wait for virtual reality, man. So basically I've got like three LED lights on the side of my headphones. And I've got a PS2 camera sitting in front of me, which picks up the LED lights and converts it. So every time it moves, it converts it. So if I have to only move my head slightly, like if I move my head now about, I don't know, 20, 30 mil to the right, now about like, so from that's 12 o'clock, 2 o'clock, and I'm looking out of the window, but I can still see the monitor. So on our right, down there, somewhere, is Bletchley. And a little bit further on, maybe if we come through this cloud, is Milton Keynes. I think we're still in the green. Pop out through the cloud, look. Gaps. Nice little steady flight. So yes, all Milton Keynes down there. It's probably all the shopping centre and everything. Milton Keynes shopping centre. Could probably. Is it? Yeah, it must be. It to our left is Stony Stratford. Stony Stratford down there. Then Wolverton is up there. No, we're actually passing Wolverton now, down there. Bloody head tracking. Used to go roller skating in Wolverton. Get the train and go roller skating. That looks, there's a caravan park there, look. That's Cosgrove. That's Cosgrove Caravan Park, look. Awesome. Never been there. Quite a fair few lakes there. So we're not far off Sywell now. Look, there's a plane. Wonder what altitudes they're going at. So there's a plane on my left somewhere, but you can't see it, it's a cloud. Probably high altitude. Plane on my left, there's a plane there. We have to come in and come around and land in Sywell from that direction. Newport Pagnell, what's that? That's the M1, isn't it? That's the M1 down there, look. Okay, I'm going to descend.
Golf Bravo Kilo traffic virtual Dave 6811 miles south 4,300 feet inbound to land runway 21 right.
The vertical speed. Can't go down. Okay, take off autopilot. Gonna hand fly it now. We should have Northampton to our left. A lot of this, the artificial intelligence placed everything, because in the UK there's not a lot of photogrammetry. It's only Southampton and Portsmouth, I think, or Plymouth photogrammetry. So when I flew over Northampton, they didn't have the express lift tower. So I scraped it from Google Maps and put it into this, because Microsoft Flight Simulator use Bing Maps. It's not so good. Not really supposed to do it, but because you're using Google's stuff for their competitor's game. We're slowly descending now through the cloud. There's a plane. It's pretty cool, look. There's another plane flying over Northampton. I didn't think a lot of planes fly over Northampton, so... Because I put the express lift tower in and something else, and I didn't upload it to the community, but I think I will. I'm just going to show you the tower that I put in. You can see it already. So that's Grange Park to our left. And then we're just coming over Wootton. It's great flying on a sim with other people. So yeah, I'll put in the Express Lift Tower and I'll put in Saints Rugby Ground, which I'll show you. East Hunsbury down there. CM1 going up. So yeah, this tower wasn't in the game, or in the simulator rather, but it is now. Courtesy of moi. I did that, and I did put the Express Lift Tower in, I put the Rugby Ground, and then I put also Northants Cricket Ground in. Oh, and I put the Saints Shop in as well. But that block of buildings there should be Beacon Bingo, but the AI has put flats there, so I need to change that. Where are we flying now? Kingsthorpe Palace, Spinney Hill. So yeah, I want to fly around, show you. Where did I put it? It's over here. Somewhere over there, there it is. I put the cricket ground in as well. It's quite a laborious task, to be honest. Putting it in, I can't even see it now. Where are you? Up in the cloud. Low level clouds, man. So we're over Abington Park at the moment, so we've got bank left now. There, you can just see it, look. It's hard to see because of the wing. If I keep banking round, it should come into view. Alexa, stop music. There Yeah, so I'll put that in as well, look. So it actually looks how it should. Slotted it into the surrounding area. Okay, let's get moving. There's a few planes are still around. And I love how it, the, look, it's gaps in the cloud, so it's casting, like, we're under a dark cloud at the moment. And then all of a sudden it gets brighter over there, look. Just flying over Kingsthorpe in a minute. Bloody head tracking. And that's Pittsford Reservoir over there. Come down in altitude slightly. Sometimes this game just freezes, just bugs out. Takes a massive dip in frames and I don't know why. Then it will just clear itself up again. A lot of people have complained about that since they updated it. Flew over Church Brampton. And Chapel Brampton is down here somewhere. Bricksworth down to our right. Pittsford Reservoir. Goldwell.
Golf Bravo Kilo traffic virtual Dave 684 miles northwest 1,700 feet inbound to land runway 21 right.
Really low level cloud, isn't it? Flaps down, flow us up.
Echo Golf Bravo Kilo traffic virtual Dave 68 is on final runway 21 right to land.
There we go.
Echo Golf Bravo Kilo traffic virtual Dave 68 is on final runway 21 right to land.
500.
Coming in a bit fast. Ooh, I took a bit of concentrating and that did. But we made it, man. Nice little touchdown. A little bit fast, but it's quite a long runway. Awesome. I love this shit. Ooh, hello. Okay. That was an accident. Didn't mean to do that. We throttled down too low. Even though there should be air traffic control here, it's not. There's none there. So I'm not getting any response, really. But still, never mind. This is an awesome sim. I just need to do a few updates, optimize everything. Update some of the... considering you can fly all over the world. And it all looks like this. It's mad. Flying over mountains and stuff. Now, where's my men? Where do you want me to go? Not here. Carry on. Maybe I'll have someone guiding me in when I come. Just here, look. My plan is eventually is to get on VATSIM, which is live air traffic control. So you've got to actually speak to somebody and they direct you. Just there, buddy, you want me? Come in. Come in, buddy. Come in, buddy. Yeah, I'm coming. Thank you, sir. So that's it. That was a little flight from High Wycombe to Sywell Airport. Don't take me to that, because I need to shut down my aircraft. I think so. I hope you stayed with me for that flight. Quite pleasurable. And, yeah, peaceful and relaxing. Just takes you away for a moment. More so for me, because I'm doing it. Well, you know, sort of. Okay, ciao.